Good morning, colleagues, and welcome to the first meeting in Session 6 of the Health, Social Care and Sports Committee. I am David Torrance, MSP for Kirkcaldy, and as the oldest member of the committee, I have the pleasure of convening this meeting for the first two items of business. I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome all members, and I look forward to working with you on this committee. Before we move to the first item on the agenda, I'd like to remind everyone present to switch mobile phones to silent, and no apologies have been received. Agenda item 1, declaration of interests. The first agenda item is for each of us to declare an interest we have that are relevant to the work of the committee. Background information is provided in the declaration of interest paper, paper 1. Can I put on record that I have no relevant interests to declare? I will now invite each committee member to declare any relevant interests. Stephanie Callahan. I'll come back to Stephanie. Sandeesh Gilhane, do you have any interest to declare?
Hello, thank you. Yes, I have a number of interests to declare. So I'm a practicing doctor working in GP and also in hospital. I'm a member of the British Medical Association. I'm a member of the Royal College of General Practitioners. I'm a member of the Royal College of Surgeons. I'm a member of the MDDUS, a defence union. And I have spoken previously on lots of health topics across BBC, TV, radio and STV.
Sandeesh, thank you. Emma Harper.
Thank you, David. Yes, I currently remain a registered nurse and I'm a member of NHS Dumfries and Galloway's vaccination team. I will continue to be available as and if required to support further COVID vaccination in the upcoming months, and I will update my register as necessary to declare any income derived when this occurs. Hey, thanks.
Thank you. Gillian Mackay.
Thank you, David. I have no relevant interest to declare.
Thank you, Gillian. Carol Mohan.
I have no relevant interest to declare. Thank you.
Thank you, Carol. Paul O'Kane.
Thank you, David. Until the 10th of May, I was Policy and Participation Manager at Enable Scotland, which is a learning disability charity and social care provider. I am currently a councillor in East Renfrewshire Council, and until the 10th of June, I was Deputy Leader of the Council and Convener for Education and Equalities, and I'm also a member of the GMB Union. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul. Evelyn Tweed.
Thank you, David. I am currently a councillor at Stirling Council and I am also a member of the GMB Trade Union. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you very much, Evelyn. Annie Wells.
I have no relevant interest to declare. Thank you.
Thank you, Annie. Can I go back to Stephanie Callahan, please, to declare any interests? I see Stephanie has left, so we'll move to agenda item 2, the choice of convener. The committee's next task is to choose a convener. The procedure is explained in the choice of convener paper 2. Parliament has agreed that only members of the Scottish National Party are eligible for nominations as convener of this committee. I invite members of that party to nominate one of their number for this post. Can I have nominations, please?
I, David, convener, I would like to nominate Gillian Martin, please.
Thank you, Emma. Is there any other nominations? Do we agree to choose Gillian Martin as our convener?
Yes.
As no member has indicated otherwise, can I congratulate Gillian on her appointment and wish her every success as convener of the Health, Social Care and Sports Committee. And I'm happy to hand over the chair. Thank you.
Thank you, David, and thank you, colleagues. I'm very pleased to be nominated, agreed as the convener for the Health, Social Care and Sport Committee. I look forward to working for you all. It's not a declaration of interest of the likes of my colleagues, but I probably should put on record that I have a daughter who is a student midwife at Robert Gordon's University and currently working in placements across all health boards in Scotland. It's maybe just best to declare that. And we will have we will be able to go to Stephanie Callaghan when she's logged on. She got thrown out of the meeting. So I'll come back to Stephanie once she's in. She'll maybe let me know in the chat box when she's in and we can get that done. So our next agenda item is agenda item 3, and our next task is to choose a deputy convener. The Parliament has agreed that only members of the Scottish Labour Party are eligible for nomination as deputy convener of this committee, and I invite members of that party to nominate one of their number for this post.
Hi, thank you, convener. Could I nominate Paul O'Kane, please?
Okay, so Carol Mochan has nominated Paul O'Kane. Do we agree to choose Paul O'Kane as a deputy convener? And I'll assume everyone does, unless someone indicates otherwise, but I'm seeing agreement across everyone's faces. That's agreed. I congratulate Paul O'Kane on his appointment as deputy convener, and I look forward very much to working with him. So agenda item 4 is a decision on taking business in private. The next item of business is a decision to whether to discuss a work programme in private at this meeting and all future meetings. Again, I'm assuming that everyone agrees unless a member indicates otherwise. Are we agreed? We are agreed. Okay, so we'll move on to agenda item 5. The committee is asked to thank the Session 5 Health and Sport Committee for its legacy paper. We wish to note it for now and agree to consider it as part of our work programme discussion. Are members content to do that? We are. Now, I'm just waiting to see if we have Stephanie back so that she can make her declaration of interest. I'm not seeing that she's here. Might we suspend briefly? Right, we can do it in private session, and it'll be. We'll make sure that it is available, so that members of the public can see her declaration of interest. So, I'm going to close the public part of this meeting, and we'll move into private session.